everybody. Welcome to another AMA. This is the first one for 2020. And I'd like to wish you all a happy new year, a very prosperous and healthy new year in 2020. If you'd be so kind, if you haven't already, please push the subscribe button. And also hit the bell so that you'll be notified for the next AMA that comes available. So today's AMA is a question I get asked a lot, and people ask me, Dr. Z, why are some models in heads and some models in combos? What's the reason? What's the benefit? What's the difference? Well, before I go through and talk about the plus and minuses of the two different designs, let me state that they're all built on the same chassis. So a head or a combo version of that same amp is exactly that same amp. Only thing that's maybe reversed is the panel, so that it's either a top mount or a bottom mount, depending upon what cabinet it goes into. But they are all identical chassis, okay? There are some pluses to combos, okay? One of them is that it's a great grab and go. Guys kind of like that, like the convenience of having a grab and go configuration that they can walk in with their guitar in one hand and their amp in the other, and they're ready to go. So it's a lot easier to carry. Also, on a combo, I can kind of control the sound of the amp a little better as a designer, because I can design the size of the cabinet and the speaker that goes inside that cab to marry it with the chassis to try to get the sound that's in my head that I would like to present as this product. So it allows me as a designer to come up with a little bit better or my vision of how the amp should sound. Another plus, combos are better as reverb amps. And the reason being, I'm able to take the reverb tub and move it further away from the power transformer, which emulates EMS or electronic noise. And the little transducers of the reverb tub will pick that up. So you get a little background noise, a little bit of hum. The further away you can put them, the less that's a problem, the quieter and nicer the reverb sounds in a combo as opposed to a head. The negative of a combo is its weight. Now, I tried in the past 5 or 6 years to use the lightest weight woods that I can, and that's poplar plies, these imported plywoods. The combos come in at around 35 to 40 pounds. Which is pretty good for an amp with a speaker, with a nice size magnet, transformers, chassis, and cabinet combined. So we try to make them as light as we can, but combos are certainly heavier. A combo's not as versatile. Okay, with a head, you're able to try different speakers, different speaker cabinets. With a combo, you're kind of locked in to what's there. And also a negative with combos is they're kind of hard on tubes. Think about it. You've got a lot of vibration, you got a lot of sound pressure with the speaker kind of right up against the tubes and the cabinet vibrating. So it does kind of vibrate the tubes a little bit, which does tend to shorten their life, cause them to be a little rattly or microphonic. So that what leads us to head designs, okay? Well, heads are nice because they're very light, easy to carry. You may have to carry two pieces because you're going to have a cabinet, but at least it's very easy to tote a head, and guys kind of like that. It's more versatile, okay? If you wanted to use two speaker cabinets with your head separated on stage, use a 410, a 412, a 212, whatever, a 115. You're able to do that with a head. You're able to get a cabinet that will give you a different voicing because of the speaker configuration. And a head allows you to do that. A head is a lot easier on tubes because there isn't that vibration. So the tubes are much more settled and they last quite a bit longer in a head. The only negative thing about a head, or what you have to consider, is that you do have to hook it up with a cabinet. So you do have to go through the trouble of trying to find and purchase different speakers, see which one you like best with it, determine yourself what you think is the optimum sound with that amp head. And, you know, that can get a little expensive and whatever, but it's all to, you know, trying to find that great sound. And that's one of the negative things about a head is, you know, you got to go through that rigmarole. So, you know, as we talked about tubes, well, you know, let me just state a fact about the current production tubes, okay? Right here I have a tube, and you can kind of see the internal construction of the tube. And, you know, I'm very thankful that vacuum tubes are still available in today. So I'm able to make tube amps for the past 32 years. But one thing is that they are getting more and more expensive, and the quality of them is kind of decaying a bit. And the reason for that is the tube manufacturers don't want to redo their dies. They don't want to retool and make new dies to make the stamps for the internal elements of this tube. When you make a die, it has a certain life. It has a certain amount of parts it can produce before it needs to be redone. And these tube manufacturers are kind of delinquent when it comes to that. So the tolerances aren't as tight. As they go beyond the lifespan of that die, they're stamping out parts that aren't quite as tight a tolerance as they were when the tube was designed. So what happens is inside, they're a little bit loose. And when the vibration of the amp and the sounds and certain notes, certain frequencies, cause you to get a little bit of a rattle on a tail. Now, it's not that bad. I mean, when you're playing live on stage, you never hear that. But it is a consideration. And, you know, heads do kind of take care of that, if you will. We have had great, great success with our JETTA amps, the JETTA combos that we built. And we've built a lot of them. But people have requested that we make a JETTA head. And so we are releasing that. So now you will be able to get a JETTA in a head configuration, as well as the 112 combo, the very popular 112 combo. So that's a new release that we have that's available today. We also have a new product that's going to be available February 3rd, and that is the Z-Rec Junior. Okay, I've had a lot of requests for a kind of a lower powered Z-Rec. People love the Z-Rec, but man, it's so loud, Z. So I kind of built a half power version of it, built it on the same chassis, using the same turret board as the standard Z-Rec. So it has that same sound, believe me. But I did add master volume, a kind of a feature that, you know, everyone kind of likes, because a post-phase inverter master volume is very, very useful. Almost like an attenuator, if you will. So February 3rd, you'll see the Z-Rec Junior available as a head and also as a 112 combo. And it'll be the top mount 112 combo loaded with a greenback, a Celestian greenback. Man, a great, great speaker for this amp. It really marries and couples perfectly. So look for that. Save your money. And you can get a great Z-Rec now that's more affordable and also more sound capable in different applications. So there you go. That's the AMA, talking about heads and combos. Hope you guys have a great day, and see you next time.